Hello student, welcome back to again another video, that is Holocephali characters and classification. I am Dr. Aruna Chakravarti, Associate Professor of Zoology, Government Dungar College, Bikaner. Holocephali. Holos means entire, cephal means head. Holocephali is very small ancient group of highly specialized marine fishes. It comprises of red-tailed fishes. They appeared first in the Lower Jurassic and at present are represented by few marine fishes. It includes the only cartilaginous fishes having fleshy operculum covering the gills. Like the Acanthodian, they seem to represent divergent and specialized descendant of some primitive lesmobranch ancestors. Now, key characters of Holocephali. Endoskeleton cartilaginous, that is calcified, persistent, unconstricted notochord, poorly developed vertebrae, holostylic jaw suspension, that is the upper jaw is immovable, united with cranium, hence the name Holocephali. Teeth united to form crushing plates, devoid of enamel. This is an adaptation for crushing mollusk, crustacean, and sea urchin. The occipital condyles are well developed and are marked better than that of shark. The gill opening are only four in number and the spiracular cleft is absent. A fleshy operculum supported by branchial rays is attached to the hyoid arch and form covering of the gills. Opening on each side. Median and paired fins are well developed, no spiracle, no air bladder and no cloaca. Absence of stomach and presence of spiral valve in the intestine. Kidney is opisthonephric, corresponding fundamental pattern of other fishes. Sexual dimorphism is well marked, female attain larger size than the male. Mature male with cephalic or frontal casper on forehead, a pair of pelvic clasper and pair of prepelvic tentacula. Oviparous, fertilization internal and cleavage holoblastic. Classification of Holocephali. Class Holocephali includes two orders, Inuopterygiformes. Inion means back of the neck, pteron means wing. Extinct group of Pennsylvanian fishes, example Inuopteryx. Some paleontologists consider them as ancestor to the present Holocephalian. This order is also known as Chondrancheliformes. Now, next order is Chimeriformes, extant living group of deep sea fishes existing from Jurassic period. There are three important genera as follows: Chimera monstrosa, snout blunt, Calorhynchus antarcticus, snout produced into rostrum, Heriota, snout long and pointed. First of all, we discuss Chimera monstrosa, commonly called the king of herrings or the rabbit fish or rat fish. This is found on the coast of Europe, Australia, Japan, New Zealand, North America and Africa. It is the only species of the genus found in India. Had the large with blunt snout, body is elongated, tapering to the whip-like tail, fleshy or skinny operculum is present. This is not homologous with the osteichthyes operculum. There are two dorsal fins and the first dorsal has a strong spine. Pelvics are abdominal in position. Anal fin is small. Tail fin is ordinary and appears like heterocircle type. Mature male has club-shaped cephalic or frontal clasper on the forehead. It is also called as tentaculum. Beside this pelvic clasper, that is myxopterygia, and prepelvic clasper are also present. All the claspers are armed with tentacles. Lateral line system has open grooves with many branches on head. Pectoral fins are large and ventrally placed. Small opening of ampulla of Lorenzini are present on the cheeks and on the bulbous snout. The notochord is persistent and there is no spiracle. The large head and eyes, huge pectoral fin, whiplash tail, and striking color give to Chimera a bizarre appearance. Now, Caelorhynchus antarcticus is abundant in South Pacific. Snout is produced into anterior rostrum that end in a ventrally directed flap, forming an important tactile organ. Tail is heterocercal. Now, Heriota is a deep sea form found in the North Atlantic. Snout is long and pointed. Pectoral fins are large. Frontal clasper is absent and the ordinary claspers are small. It has an elongated, tapering and depressed rostrum. The tail is not turned upward. Now, biology of holocephalians. External features of holocephaly. Body appearance is shark-like, but the head is large and compressed, having a small mouth. Operculum is formed by a fold of skin to cover the gill slits so that a single branchial aperture is found. Spiracle and cloaca are absent. Two dorsal and a ventral fin present. Tail appears to the heterocercal, but in Chimera it is wipe-like. The pectoral as well as pelvic fin are large and the anal fin is small. The urogenital aperture is distinct from the anus. Sexes are separate and sexual dimorphism well marked. Females are larger than the males. Males having cephalic or frontal clasper on forehead covered with denticles. Skin is smooth and silvery. Lateral line system has open grooves with many branches on head. Now, endoskeleton. The vertebral column consists of a persistent, unconstricted notochord, poorly developed vertebrae with cartilaginous arches. In Chimera, calcified rings are embedded in the notochord sheet. The neural arches of first 3-4 vertebrae are fused, forming a plate and give attachment to the first dorsal fin. Holostylic skull and palato quadrate fuse with cranium. Lateral cartilage are fully developed. The occipital condyles are well developed. Jaw suspension is autostylic. In Caelorhynchus, 3 cartilaginous rod grow forward from the cranium, providing support to the snout. Such rods are very much reduced in Chimera. The nasal capsules are devoid of cartilaginous wall and are therefore continuous with the cranial cavity. The hyomandibular does not participate in the suspension of the jaw. Such suspension is often called holostylic to emphasize that it probably evolved independently of that in dipnoan and the tetrapods. There are 5 gill arches with 4 gill opening protected by cover. The spiracular cleft is completely closed. All the pterygiophores of the first dorsal fin are fused into single plate. The remaining fins and the pectoral girdle are on elasmobranch pattern. Each pelvic half consists of a narrow iliac region and a broad pubo-ischial region. A fleshy operculum supported by branchial rays is attached to the hyoid arch and form covering of the gill opening on each side. Craniovertebral joint. Specialized type of flexibility is accomplished between the skull and the vertebral column. Such a joint is of special interest because the chondrocranium extend behind into a saddle-shaped surface to articulate with the centrum of the first vertebra and bears a facet for articulation with the neural arch of the first vertebra, now fins and locomotion. There are two dorsal fins. Usually the first dorsal has strong spines as in Chimera. Anal fin is small. Tail is of ordinary heterocercal type, but in Chimera and Hydrolagus, it is of isocercal type. The paired fins are represented by a set of large pectoral and smaller pelvic fins. Pelvics are abdominal in position. The graceful flapping movement of large size pectoral fin enables the holocephalian to swim by sculling the body in contrast to the swimming of the shark. Now, digestive system. The mouth in holocephaly is small as compared to the wide mouth of elasmobranch. It is mounted by the three lips-like fold and equipped with the tooth plates having irregular surface and sharp cutting edges. The tooth plates have reduced pulp cavity and the layer of enamel replaced by vasodentine. Vomerine, palatine and mandibular teeth are present. The gut is straight and simple tube. A short esophagus opens behind directly into a broad intestine and the latter into a short rectum, opening to the exterior by an anal aperture. The true stomach is altogether absent and the intestine has a well-developed spiral valve. Respiratory system. A mandibular pseudobranch is absent. The hyoid bears only a posterior hemibranch. The first, second and third branchial arches have holobranch, but the fourth has hemibranch. The fifth arch is gill-less and leg a cleft between it and its predecessor. Circulatory system. Heart is built upon the pattern similar to other fishes. The heart consists of sinus venosus, atrium, ventricle and conus with three rows of valves. The holocephalian retain urea in the blood for osmoregulation as in shark. Now nervous system. Cerebellum is small. Medulla oblongata is produced laterally into restiform bodies. The cerebral hemisphere are small and each is connected with an olfactory bulb by means of a narrow peduncle. Diencephalon is long and trough-shaped. The small rounded pineal body is present at the end of a pineal stalk. Now urogenital system. The kidney of holocephalian is opisthonephric, having a large number of uriniferous tubules and built upon the basic pattern of other fishes. The peritoneal funnel are absent in holocephalian, but the abdominal pores are present. Unisexual. Clasping organ are remarkable in males only. Females attain larger size than the males. The male reproductive system consists of testes, vasa deferens, epididymis, and vesicula seminalis. The testes are large oval bodies but contain only immature sperm. The sperm become mature in the epididymis and form spermatophores. Vesicula seminalis is divided internally into several chambers by means of transverse septa. The spermatophores are stored in this compartment and are finally released into the urinogenital sinus. The female reproductive organ resembles those of the elasmobranch and consists of a pair of ovaries, shell glands, and uteri. Fertilization. The fertilization is internal and the cleavage holoblastic type. The incubation period is fairly long. For example, Calorhynchus, it extends from 9 to 12 months. Egg and development. The holocephalians are oviparous. Their eggs are characteristically spindle-shaped and are surrounded by horny egg capsule secreted by the shell glands. The capsules of Hydrolagus measure about 15 cm and those of Calorhynchus coli about 25 cm in length. The eggs are laid in pairs and contain three compartments. Now, sensory organs. Holocephalian eyes are large in relation to the body size, presumably as an adaptation to their total dark habitat in the deep sea. The lateral line canals are open and are specially developed on the head and on the underside of snout. They differ from those of the elasmobranch, possibly because of a change in the snout structure or the style of their food detection. The membranous labyrinth typically consists of three semicircular canals. The vertical canal forming the serous also receives the horizontal canal. The endolymphatic duct opens externally by a pore. Now, affinities. Affinities of holocephali. Holocephali occupies a position in between the cartilaginous and bony fishes and have conserved certain of the primitive characteristics from their placoderm ancestors. They show resemblance with the elasmobranchs on one hand and the teleost on the other. They also possess a number of well-defined characters that are peculiar to the group and entitle them to be separate class. Now, resemblance with elasmobranchi. Holocephalian show both the character of Paleozoic elasmobranch as well as those of modern living shark. Differences from elasmobranch: holostylic jaw suspension, no spiracle, presence of skinny operculum, an extra pelvic clasper and cephalic clasper in male. Primitive shark features of holocephali. The tail is heterocercal. A stiff spine along the anterior edge of the first dorsal spine is retained from the ancient shark. Mouth plays ventrally as also in the modern shark. Now, modern shark features of holocephali. Skin smooth and silvery. Cartilaginous endoskeleton, devoid of any replacing or dermal bones. The vertebral column is ancestrous and ribless, consisting of persistent notochord with cartilaginous arches. lack of bony jaws. Simplified brain, diencephalon only elongated due to large size eyes. The general development of chondrocranium, a pair of clasper present posterior to the pelvic fin in the male, as in elasmobranch. Beside this, anterior clasper and the frontal claspers are also present in holocephali. The paired fins and girdles are built upon the elasmobranch pattern. The tail is heterocercal. The nasal and labial cartilage along with the orbital margin of cartilage are present. Air bladder is absent. A spiral valve is present in the intestine. A separate posterior superficial ophthalmic foramen is present. The reproductive organ on the elasmobranch pattern, the conus arteriosus, is present in the heart, contain three rows of valves. Urea is retained in the blood for osmoregulation. Presence of egg capsule, the lateral line canal are distinct and suggestive of the shark. Excretory system on the elasmobranch pattern. Resemblance with dipnoi. Nature of skull, unconstricted notochord, presence of crushing tooth plates. Now resemblance with teleost. An operculum is present so that the gills do not open directly to the exterior but into a common chamber situated beneath the operculum. Single external branchial chamber is present. Reduced interbranchial septum, allowing gill filament to project beyond it. Spiracle is absent. Cloaca absent. Four complete aortic arches serving the four gill opening. Now, primitive characteristics. Cartilaginous endoskeleton. Persistent notochord with cartilaginous arches. Separate external opening for each gill slits. Large opercular covering of the gill slits. Now, specialized features. Jaw suspension holostylic, presence of unusual frontal claspers, and absence of scales. Now, resemblance with placoderm. Holocephalian show close relationship with some placoderm like Rhamphodopsis and Tenurella in the following points. Presence of large labial cartilage, presence of large tooth plates, presence of long tail, presence of a pair of rostral processes to support fleshy snout, presence of prepelvic clasper in male, and presence of short and deep palatochondrate. So thank you, student. Thanks for watching.